So thank you once more for joining us here. Now, what we just witnessed in this short film is nothing less than the latest creation, the latest development from Krones. This is something that is already in operation. We've just heard about it a few minutes ago, if you were already around. And this is a solution that is so unique that we are convinced here at Krones that this is going to lead the way and pave the way into the future to come. Now, how so? Of course, you now have lots of questions in your mind. How so? We're about to find out by an expert, not anyone, but the perfect person to give us even more details, because this is someone who is not only in charge of solutions, of line solutions. This is someone who has been with Krones for over 35 years now. So naturally, he has seen a lot of innovations through, right? And this one, he still claims, stands out from the crowd. So that's very special. We're going to find out how so. Starting off, please give a round of applause for the expert to my right. This is Head of Business Line, Line Solutions, Stefan Raith. All right, Stefan, okay, as so, we... Yeah. As we get established with our clickers and make sure the presentation is up and running, first of all, let me just ask you the first question, and then we'll walk through this. We'll work through the technical details. Stefan, you told me to know where we stand today and to look into the future, we need to look back at the last drinktec, correct?
Yeah. So first of all, Jasmine, thank you for the introduction. I'm really glad to be here. And honestly, I'm also a little bit excited, because we would like to show something special. We have a solution we haven't been decided and developed before. So this is something really I would like to show to you. And the question was, we started here 3 years ago on the drinktec in 2022. And that's absolutely, and yeah, it should work, I thought. So we should need now the next slide, hopefully.
All right. Maybe we'll just keep on talking through it.
Yeah, and then we'll the slide will come, hopefully.
Hope that it's up and running in just a few moments.
So as I mentioned, 3 years ago on the drinktec in 2022. So we started here at Krones with our vision, but also with the challenges we all faced together. And the challenges, just a few of them, have been, for example, on plastic littering or plastic entry. We did have topics like the climate change, but also feeding the world. So all about these different challenges we did have on our agenda in the last spring, we also have shown some solutions on that. For example, on the climate change, we brought solutions for reducing of CO2 emissions in a bottling plant. And for sure, we as Krones, we also will focus also in future on these challenges.
Thank you, Stefan, for that trip down memory lane, and pardon the technical difficulties. Now you have the visuals to go with what Stefan was saying. How many of you were actually around for last drinktec in 2022? Oh, okay. Well, I wasn't, but good for you. You didn't miss out. So I think for those who weren't around, perhaps like myself, Stefan, can you explain what evolved of what we're just seeing here from last drinktec?
Yeah, absolutely. So because it's very important to come back what was happened here 3 years ago. And it was unique at Krones that we did ask our customer in a so-called vision area. Because for us, it was very important, how does our customers would like to see the future? So kind of this, what is the line of the future? We got so many statements, ideas, and information that, as we just did ask, who was joining at this time. So maybe you remember on all the pictures our artists have drawn on this black wall, as we can see on the presentation in the background, okay? So all this stuff was coming up, and we carefully listened to our customer, and the final topic we said we have to focus on is on a comprehensive performance across the entire life cycle. And now, Jasmine, I'm not only talking about lines and machines on developments. Now it's coming something different on top. And it's we are talking about TCO, so total cost of ownership, but also as well an OEE, so overall effectiveness of the equipment. And these topics together will help us to create something new. So we started right after drinktec with a new development program. And with this development program, I'm really proud to be here today to say, first time, we have a solution already in operation, which is also accepted by our customer.
And we're going to, thank you, Stefan, circle back round to some of the things you were just sharing. So this, what we're seeing here on the visuals and this major development initiative, this actually transferred into this this solution that you were speaking of, this unique solution. I think all we're missing now is the name. We heard it earlier before, but for anyone who wasn't yet around just 20 minutes ago, please, now give us the name. This is the moment.
Yeah, as I said, it was also very important for us that we have a new solution, and the new solution should also get a new name. And the new name is Ingeniq. So Ingeniq means for us, it's a combination of two worlds. It's ingenuity and IQ. So we want to show the innovation and also the intelligence of this new solution. And it will express the seamless fusion of machine, software, and services.
Okay, Stefan. I don't know how you feel, but I was expecting some sort of firework and parade when you said Ingeniq. What happened to that? What's going on?
It was actually, we thought about, okay, but if you think about the facility here, it's not so easy to do a firework. Maybe it's not a smart one, okay? But luckily to our board, we could use all the investment to get more beer to our hospitality area. So at the end of the day, my expectation to our customers is to have at least one more beer on Ingeniq.
Will you be able to do that for us? All right, I'm thinking that they appreciate this initiative as well, and the beer garden being right over there where the bright lights are, it's hard to miss. But without wanting to give away or spoiler too much, there may actually be fireworks later on, all right? So don't wander off too far. Thank
but
you
Jasmine,
for that.
Yes. Shh, yes. This was actually a secret. You cannot spoiler about on this one.
I
hope that our customers staying here and will find out what does it mean, okay?
Okay, they will stay here to find out for themselves. Now, Stefan, let's come back to Ingeniq for a minute. We'll get back to the beer later. But we keep on saying Ingeniq is so unique, right? So what exactly differentiates Ingeniq, not only when it comes to the setup, but also when it comes to the mindset that goes with this brand new setup?
Yeah, so at the end of the day, it's really a comprehensive new solution. And what you can see on this slide behind us, it's an infinity loop. You also will find the infinity loop over your left side here. And it's a combination of three different topics. So at the end of the day, Ingeniq, it's a technologically leading bottling line, always connected to Krones, and combined with a lifecycle alliance contract. And this one will be something very new in our industry. So saying on this infinity loop here, we have three building blocks actually. On the left side, we have the high-end equipment or the line itself. So on that, the line is modular, it's future ready, and also it's intelligent, it's also technologically leading. And what does it mean? I would like to give you an example on that. We can see on the left or your right side here, there are no material support, okay? And this means that there will be no, again, there will be no operator intervention on supplying our tray packer, for example, with a foam roll, but the same on supplying a labeling machine with a label reel. All this stuff will be done automatically by a robot or by AGVs. So, coming to the second, it's connect and secure. And this means that the line is always digital connected, digital ready. We always have the basis for remote service of Krones, and it's also data-driven. So, and data-driven is the key word, in my opinion, what we need for our third building block, which is the lifecycle alliance. And here we come to something new, as I said before. The lifecycle alliance, it's a performance promise on cost and output per pallet. And this comes across the entire life cycle of a line. So in summary, just in a nutshell to bring it together, it means we as Krones, in alliance with our customer, are responsible for cost and performance of the line. So will come a performance-based payment contract behind. And that, Jasmine, it's a novelty in our industry.
And it is not only a novelty, it's a huge amount of responsibility as partner that you're taking over. So naturally, we are, again, very convinced that this is indeed the way to pave the future. Thank you for that. And I hate to use the buzzword, but this is a true game changer in our opinion. It's going to be. So I think one question that remains is, are we going to be seeing other Ingeniq lines, right? Are there going to be cans, for example?
Yeah, absolutely. So as I mentioned already, we started with Ingeniq PET lines and we sold one. We have one in operation and it's also accepted. But since you could spoil it before, I guess I also can do it. And we have already four more lines on order. So in summary, we have already five Ingeniq PET lines up to now. And that's really cool because if you look back on the time 3 years ago where we stand here, okay, and it have all these vision discussions with our customers, and now we have already five lines on order, and one is already accepted, so it's really cool. And as you...
Worth an applause.
Thank you, and as you already did ask, how does it go on? So we are still working on the next line type, so we are also on can lines, glass lines, also on aseptic and PET CSD lines. So all this will come within the next years and will be on sold also.
That is incredible and an incredible speed, so congratulations to Krones for that. There was a moment earlier when we realized here on stage, looking into the audience, your eyes started to sparkle and light up. It was when he mentioned the costs, when he mentioned lowering TCO. So we need to circle back around to that, Stefan. TCO, lowering that, what does that mean in numbers?
Yeah, I would like to make it in a use case we have done for this PET Ingeniq line, which was also sold first time. So at the end of the day, you can see on the left side here, what are the traditional business case or business model we have behind on a typical PET line. And it's a case study or concept study behind where all the TCOs over 10 years are collected in this TCO situation, what we can see here. And at the end of the day, the change will be that there is a cost change, which comes with a higher investment on Krones' scope of supply, but also on a significant reduction on the other cost drivers we have in the TCO. So finally, there will be a TCO reduction of 10% feasible with Ingeniq. So we are, as a partner, takes responsibility, as I said before, for performance on one side, but also for costs on the other side, across the entire life cycle of a line.
All right, so we have the numbers, TCO as a focal point. We've got the beer garden. If there's anyone here now, or anyone watching online who is now still not convinced, Stefan, if they're still saying, what isn't it for me as a partner, as a customer, why should I decide to do this? What do you have to say to them?
So I would like to at least summarize a few features, not all because I guess it's too many as we said before, but starting with the output, we will have more output than ever before with Ingeniq. Again, there is a performance promise behind. We have this minimal operator binding, for example, on the autonomous material supply, I have explained a little bit before. And for sure, sustainability is still in focus because also Ingeniq is Enviro certified. Then the line is digital visible for both, for customer, but also for us. And it's a baseline for our Connect and Secure contract. And as I mentioned now several times, I guess, we have the lowest OPEX because we have a performance-based payback contract within the Lifecycle Alliance.
Where can your customers learn more, not only here with us, with the team in conversation, but afterwards in retrospect?
So already said before a little bit, we have here on the left side from your side, we have the Infinity Loop, where we have the experts on all getting the details on the Lifecycle Alliance. So we are right in the middle of our Ingeniq booth, where we simulate a line with our containers, with our show, which is, in my opinion, really great. And also here, we have many experts who can help you and give you more information, whatever you need. And don't forget these three building blocks out of Ingeniq. Number one, it's the line itself. Number two is Connect and the Cure. And the third one is the Lifecycle Alliance.
And I promise by the end of the week, you will be able to say those if we wake you up at night. All right, you're going to learn those by heart. We will be back all week. We have lots of novelties to share, but we will be speaking of a lot of the points that Stefan was just getting at. So be sure to stick around. It's going to be a really exciting week. We're thrilled to be able to kick it off with all of you. So thank you so much for joining us. And please follow up on this formal invitation to have a conversation. Strike up a chat with our team. No matter how serious they look, we're in Germany. It's normal. They're actually quite friendly, and they're looking for conversation, okay? Yeah, he understands. All right. So feel free. Do not hesitate, and we look forward to answering any question you may have. Thanks again for tuning in online, and let's hear it one more time for the fantastic Stefan Raith, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jasmine. Thank you.